I don't know. I never thought I would want to look at a circle on the floor so bad. It's actually very comfortable to look in this way because I've looked at this my whole life. I've seen this, but it's emotional to see it from this angle. So shows that dreams sure come true. I'm Tim Duggar, and this is my Opry debut. Well, here it is Wednesday. Another happy hour, two for one. I got a call that says, hey, December 3rd, you're playing the Grand Ole Opry. And I didn't even need to look at my calendar. I was like, yeah, I'm good that day. How's it going? Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
I'm well. Welcome to the Opry.
So I grew up in Roanoke, Alabama. It's right on the Alabama-Georgia line. Dad was a long-distance truck driver. So he would come home with all these cassette tapes, and I mean bags full of them from, you know, stopping at truck stops and getting tapes, and I found them. I just started listening, and it was stuff that a, you know, 4 or 5 year old kid shouldn't be into. I mean, it was a lot of classic country music, and for some reason, I just fell in love with it. I would tell people, I don't know about drinking or being in love, but I sure love these songs about it. My wife's here. She told me today, she's like, this is bigger than our wedding day.
Watching your husband or your person achieve their dreams, I don't even know that proud is the, can really encompass all of it. We just feel like so blessed. I have no words. 10 years ago, we stood side stage and I took a picture of him looking out. I posted and said, one day soon, this, you know, he'll be making his Opry debut. And it just is a reminder that, you know, it's not our timing, it's God's timing. And, your one day soon might be 10 years, it might be 10 months. Tim and I say, keep believing and keep digging. It's kind of like a racing term too, just keep digging, keep digging.
He's making his Grand Ole Opry debut. Will you welcome Curb Records recording artist, Tim Duggar.
Dale Earnhardt Jr. is a really good buddy of mine. As soon as he found out, he said, we're gonna be there. We're not missing it. And him and his wife, Amy, they're just some of our closest friends.
I don't know really how to articulate what a night like this is like for Tim. I would say that it's like being in your first Daytona 500. And I've watched him make music. I've watched him work hard to make music and make better music. And I've been a friend long enough to see him at the lowest of lows and at the highest of highs. You know, this is what I think every artist hopes for, is that moment where they can go, man, I belong, you know, and I made it.
Dude, this is awesome.
Man, this is something.
And so can I go in there and circle?
No, you don't get to step in the
circle. I don't
want to
step in it. It's
I don't think they mind. Can we walk out there around it?
Walking out on stage, getting up close to that circle is pretty powerful. It's special that my first time here is to be able to experience one of my friend's first trips on stage. It's like watching a race and having somebody in that race to cheer for.
One night we sat down and talked about what our goals were. Well, our prayer has been that he gets to play on the Opry. In recent months, his dad has taken a decline in his health, so our prayer has changed to let me make that stage, or you know, my debut when my dad can be there. So he'll be front row.
You know, he's gonna win the night. He's gonna have a great experience. He's gonna sound amazing.
Mom and Dad, we made it up here, all right?
Might as well buy a bar, rack them up, make a little money while we drink too much till all my buddies make themselves at home. Lock the door and get our last call on all night. Don't it make perfect whiskey sense to be candy?
Take a look out at that view, Tim Duggar. That's a standing ovation at the Grand Ole Opry. Soak it in for a second, my friend. Soak it in for a second.